I'm exact weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your afternoon video cast. Well, let's take a look outside. For that, we use our dome camera, and as you can see, we do have a little bit of cloud cover, but we have some blue sky as well, so we'll go with this mixture till we start working in a little more daytime heating. Have a look at the satellite and radar imagery. Earlier this morning, we saw a few spotty showers popping up, mainly along the Mississippi Gulf Coast, but notice what's behind me. Big old mess. Lots of yellows, oranges, and reds. All of that is moving our way out of ahead of it, picking up what we call a surface trough ahead of it being a cold front. So take a look at your exact cast headlines. The weekend does look like it's going to be on the wet side. Now, earlier this morning on your Friday, looks like it was going to be a total washout. Now the models have changed a little bit. That cold front that's going to push through, now the models are saying, well, it might just make it to the Gulf of Mexico. And if it does that, things will be pretty nice around here by Sunday afternoon. But it has to make it to the Gulf, and I still think that's up for some debate. Either way, we are going to see some locally heavy rainfall and the possibility of some street flooding regardless of the timing of the front. Quick look at the tropics right now. Not a whole lot going on. Still tracking this little area of disturbed weather. 20% chance. And this might become what a hybrid low. Cross between a tropical low and a regular low. That's going to keep on moving out into the Atlantic. And we're going to refocus our attention on this little feature down here. Now with a 70% chance or a medium chance on your Friday. On Thursday, this was 70%. So this has been reduced and environmental conditions not really looking too conducive for further development. So we're going to see how that plays out. This model right here is showing that this area of low pressure is going to kind of meander and hang out down here. But notice what's happening. All this moisture is being tossed onshore. There's our front. This is 11 o'clock on Saturday. If you're going to the LSU game, be ready for some rainfall. You may want to bring the poncho. And then notice what happens. The front kind of clears out, but we do have this conveyor belt of moisture that's going to move through the region, and that's going to allow the front, as it pushes through, to have lots of moisture to work with. 8 o'clock this evening, notice just a few spotty showers. The front still off to the northwest. As we get going, watch your timestamp. We're going to take it all the way to about 10:30 on Saturday morning. Look at this low that develops just off the coast. This is not going to be a tropical low. This is going to be a regular, if you will, low pressure system. But what it's going to do is provide a little more lift, because you got to have lift to get the rain, and some moisture. So there's the front. Now let's see what happens as we move ahead in time. Watch the timestamp up here. This is 6:30. Baton Rouge situated in this general area. Game starts at 6:45. Now, it looks like it might make it through. Now, earlier runs of this model still kept the front lagging back here. This is overnight Saturday night into Sunday morning. By the time we get to about 7:30 Sunday morning, notice where the front is kind of hung up to the south. But so we'll see. I think the model's still trying to figure out what's going to happen. But nonetheless, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start off with a whopping 70% chance of rain at 2 o'clock, temperatures in the mid-80s. By 6 o'clock through 10 o'clock, going to drop rain chances to 40%. If we're lucky, the rain will pass right before, right after the game starts. And notice your temperatures will stay mild, basically in the lower to mid-80s. Then on Sunday, if you're going to the Saints game, going to hold steady with a 30 to 40% chance of rain. If we get lucky, that front will push all the way to the south and not affect any tailgating around the Superdome on Sunday morning. We'll see how that plays out. Temperatures generally will be running in the mid-80s. For your Friday, we're looking at highs in the upper 80s to lower 90s, a 40% chance of rain. It'll be breezy. Look out for that localized heavy downpour, heavy rainfall. 30% chance of rain overnight, mid to upper 70s. That'll be your lows. I think we'll see a few spotty showers in the overnight hours. And your 7-day exact cast. So, going to keep your rain chances Saturday high at about 80%. Then I've reduced it a little bit to 40%. Fall does arrive, by the way, on Sunday. But notice rain, unfortunately, looks like it's going to stay in the forecast. I'm not trusting the models yet and as to how far south that front gets. All indications are it is going to be hung up at least between Lake Pontchartrain and the Gulf of Mexico, keeping about a 30 to 40% chance of rain in the forecast through next Wednesday and Thursday. There's your look at weather. Thanks for logging on.